Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel NCRT Maths with Bardeep. Today we are going to start a new chapter of grade 8, that is chapter number 3, Understanding Quadrilaterals. This is an introduction video of this chapter and we will cover all the important topics to be included in this chapter. So let's see first of all, what is a closed figure? As you already know, quadrilateral means any polygon which is of four sides. But before going into detail, what are the different types of quadrilaterals, we should cover all these topics. First one is closed figure. So any shape whose starting point and end point meet are called closed figures. For example, this triangle, this starts from this point, like starts from this point and then ends also at the same point. This is a closed figure. Okay, so this shape also, that means closed figure, can be made up of any line segments or any curves. In this shape also, the curve is starting, suppose, from this point, it will go around and then come back to its original point. So this is also a closed figure. Or we can say there are shapes that start and end at the same point and have no open ends are called closed shapes. So what is an open figure? Opposite of this, that is any shape whose line segments or curves do not meet are called open shapes. Suppose in this figure also, we can see that a shape starts from this point, goes around this, here, this side, and then it ends here. Its starting point is this, ending point is this, and they are not same. So this is an open figure. This also, it seems to be like a quadrilateral, but see, starting point and ending point are not same. So this is also referred as an open figure. So we can say that they do not start and end at the same point. So we can say that any shape whose starting point and ending point is same, that is called a closed figure, but whose starting point and ending point are not same, that is an open figure. Next is polygons. A simple closed curve made up of only line segments. Now the first thing is it should be closed. Closed means its starting point and ending point should be same. And second is it should be made up of only line segments. Closed figure or open figure can be made up of line segments or curves. But for polygons, two conditions are there. First of all, it should be a closed figure. Second is it should be made up of line segments. There should be no curves included in the polygons. So what are the different types of polygons that we will discuss later? For example, for this we can say that if this shape, it starts from this point and goes around this point and ends at the same point, this is a polygon. Why? Because its starting and ending point are same. And second is it is made up of line segments. For this shape also, same thing. It is made up of line segments and it is a closed figure, right? But for this, this is not a polygon. Why? Because one condition is fulfilled, that it is made up of line segments. But the second one, or the basic, that is it should be closed. But see, starting and ending points are not same. So this will not be referred as a polygon, right? Second is diagonal. So that means now we will consider that the figure given to you is a polygon. That means its starting point and ending point will be same. Second is it is made up of only line segments. Now what are diagonals? A line segment connecting two non-consecutive vertices of a polygon. Vertices means these corners. This we have already discussed in your previous grades. So what are vertices? These corners are called vertices. And these line segments are called edges. Okay, so now what is a diagonal? That means we will consider any point and then consecutive vertices we will skip and the remaining vertices we will join. For example, for this, if I am looking for A, this is the consecutive vertex of A, that is B and D. So I cannot join B and D because they are already joined in a figure. So what is the remaining vertex? It is C here. So the line A to C is a diagonal because it is joining the non-consecutive vertices. Okay. So similarly, if we consider B, for B also we cannot join A and C because already joined and they are edges. So B will be joined with D. So BD is a diagonal and AC is also a diagonal. So we can see here that in this rectangle ABCD we have only two diagonals, but it is not compulsory that every figure should have two diagonals. It depends on the number of vertices of your polygon. For example, in this pentagon we can see ABCDE, five sided polygon. So if we start from here, that is A, so we cannot use AB and AE as diagonal because they are edges. So what we will do is we will join A with non-consecutive vertices, that is this with C and then D. So these two diagonals are for vertices A. So now B, see B again cannot be joined with A and C. So B should be joined with A, sorry, B should be joined with E and D, right? A vertex has two diagonals, B also has two diagonals. Now let's focus on C. Again, CD and CB are edges. So we will join C with E. Okay, let's join. And second should be C with A, already joined, so we will not make it again. So next comes D. So for D, A and B are non-consecutive vertices. So D should be joined with A, already joined, and D is also joined with B, already done. So now let's come here E. For E, what are the non-consecutive vertices? That is C and B. So already we have joined. So we can say that any polygon can have n number of diagonals depending upon the number of non-consecutive vertices. Okay. So next important topic is that is interior and exterior of a closed curve. So first thing is the figure should be closed. That means starting and ending point should be same. Second is what is interior. So any point or the region inside that your closed figure is called interior. Okay. I can say that this, let it be A point. Since A lies inside region of your figure, means this is the boundary of the figure. Okay. And any point which lies inside this area is called interior, and all the outside region is exterior. So this point, let it be B. This is exterior of your closed curve and A is interior of your closed curve. So what is interior and exterior? So interior means the region inside your figure, that is interior, and the region that is outside your figure, that is exterior of your closed curve. Okay. So now let's move on to the next topic. So now let's see what are the different types of polygons. Polygon can be concave polygons or convex polygons. So now what is the meaning of that? Let's see what is convex polygon. When we join any two points in the interior of a polygon, the line joining them should completely lies inside it. That means anywhere you can take two points inside or interior of a polygon, if you join those points, full line segment should lie in the interior of your polygon. If that is so, that polygon will be a convex polygon. But if the line segment does not lie completely inside, some portion is outside that, or some portion is in the exterior of the polygon, that polygon will be concave polygon. So let's see the examples here. This is a hexagon. Suppose I have taken any two points. When I join these points, this full line segment lies in the interior. So that means this is a convex polygon. Anywhere you can take. Suppose one point is here, one point is here, and when you join these two points, this line is completely in the interior. So this is a convex polygon. Same is for this figure also. But now let's consider this polygon. Okay, so this polygon, see, according to the definition of polygon, all these are having starting and ending point same or closed figures. Second is they are made up of line segments. So polygons are for sure. But now let us see, if I take these two points and I join it, this lies in the interior. But this does not mean that this is a convex. So let's consider these two points. Okay. So when we join these two points, this portion of the line segment is in the exterior of your polygon. So now this polygon will be a concave polygon. Right. So now these further polygons or convex polygons can be further differentiated in the form of regular or irregular polygons. Regular polygons should satisfy two conditions, that is, they should be equiangular. Second is, they should be equilateral. Means equiangular means all angles of the polygon should be same. Equilateral means all the sides of the figure should be of same length. Okay, if any condition does not hold, that will be a irregular polygon. So let's see here. This is an equilateral triangle. So what are the properties of equilateral triangle? That is, length of all three sides of a triangle are equal. So that means AB is equal to AC is equal to BC. So since all sides are of same length, this is equilateral. Second is, we know that each angle of equilateral triangle is 60 degree. So that means this is equiangular also. Since both properties are true, so equilateral triangle is a regular polygon. Okay. Second is, let us consider this rectangle ABCD. In rectangle, what are the properties? We know that all angles or each angle of the rectangle is always 90 degrees. Since all angles are 90 degrees, so this is equiangular. Second is, only opposite sides of a rectangle are of equal length. That means AB is equal to DC and AD is equal to BC. Since all sides are not equal, so we cannot say that this is equilateral. So this is a polygon but irregular polygon. So whenever you see regular polygon term in your question, that means all sides are of equal length, all angles are of equal measure. Okay, so I hope all these topics are clear. So this is all about this video. See you in my next video with the remaining topics of this chapter. Thank you.